The following is a free-for-download audiobook available on Google Drive. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 12, Chapter 2, The Symptoms of Kali Yuga. This chapter relates that when the bad qualities of the age of Kali will increase to an intolerable level, the Supreme Personality of Godhead will descend as Kalki to destroy those who are fixed in irreligion. After that, a new Satya Yuga will begin. As the age of Kali progresses, all good qualities of man diminish and all impure qualities increase. Atheistic systems of so-called religion become predominant, replacing the codes of Vedic law. The kings become just like highway bandits. The people in general become dedicated to low occupations, and all the social classes become just like Shudras. All cows become like goats, all spiritual hermitages become like materialistic homes, and family ties extend no further than the immediate relationship of marriage. When the age of Kali has almost ended, the Supreme Personality of Godhead will incarnate. He will appear in the village Shambhala, in the home of the exalted Brahmana Vishnuyasa, and will take the name Kalki. He will mount his horse, Devadatta, and taking his sword in hand, will roam about the earth, killing millions of bandits in the guise of kings. Then the signs of the next Satyuga will begin to appear, when the moon, sun, and the planet Brihaspati enter simultaneously into one constellation and conjoin in the new lunar mansion Pushya, Satyuga will begin. In the order of Satya, Treta, Dwapara, and Kali, the cycle of four ages rotates in the society of living entities in this universe. The chapter ends with a brief description of the future dynasties of the moon, or the sun and moon, coming from Vajrasvata Manu in the next Satyuga. Even now, two saintly Kshatriyas are living who will, at the end of this Kali Yuga, will reinitiate the pious dynasties of the sun god Vibhishan and the moon god Chandra. One of these kings is Devapi, a brother of Maharaj Shantanu, and the other is Maru, a descendant of Ikshvaku. They are biding their time incognito in a village named Kalapa. Text 1. Shukadeva Goswami said, "Then, O King, religion, truthfulness, cleanliness, tolerance, mercy, duration of life, physical strength, and memory will all diminish day by day because of the powerful influence of the age of Kali." Purport. During the present age, Kali Yuga, practically all desirable qualities will gradually diminish as described in this verse. For example, Dharma, which indicates a respect for higher authority that leads one to obey religious principles, will diminish. In the Western world, theologians have been unable to scientifically present the laws of God, or indeed God himself, and thus, in Western intellectual history, a rigid dichotomy has risen between theology and science. In an attempt to resolve this conflict, some theologians have agreed to modify their doctrines so that they conform not only to proven scientific facts, but even to pseudo-scientific speculations and hypotheses, which, although unproven, are hypocritically included within the realm of, quote, science, end quote. On the other hand, some fanatical theologians disregard the scientific method altogether and insist on the veracity of their antiquated sectarian dogmas. Thus bereft of systematic Vedic theology, material science has moved into the destructive realm of gross materialism, while speculative Western philosophy has drifted into the superficiality of relativistic ethics and inconclusive linguistic analysis. With so many of the best Western minds dedicated to materialistic analysis, naturally most of Western religious life, separated from the intellectual mainstream, is dominated by irrational fanaticism and unauthorized mystic and mystery cults. People have become so ignorant of the science of God that they often lump the Krishna consciousness movement in with this odd assortment of fanciful attempts at theology and religion. Thus, Dharma, or true religion, which is strict and conscious obedience to God's law, is diminishing. Satyam, truthfulness, is also diminishing because people do not know what the truth is. Without knowing the absolute truth, one cannot clearly understand the real significance or purpose of life merely by amassing huge quantities of relative or hypothetical truths. Kshama, tolerance or forgiveness, is diminishing as well, because there is no practical method by which people can purify themselves and thus become free of envy. Unless one is purified by chanting the holy names of the Lord in an authorized program of spiritual improvement, the mind will be overwhelmed by anger, envy, and all sorts of small-mindedness. Thus, Daya, mercy, is also increasing. All living beings are eternally connected by their common participation in the divine existence of God. When this existential oneness is obscured through atheism and agnosticism, people are not inclined to be merciful to one another. They cannot recognize their self-interest in promoting the welfare of other living beings. In fact, people are no longer even merciful to themselves. They systematically destroy themselves through liquor, drugs, alcohol, meat-eating, sexual promiscuity, and whatever other cheap gratificatory processes are available to them. Because of all these self-destructive practices and the powerful influence of time, the average lifespan, ayur, is decreasing. Modern scientists, seeking to gain credibility among the mass of people, often publish statistics showing that science has increased the average duration of life. But these statistics do not take into account the number of people killed through the cruel practice of abortion. When we figure aborted children into the life expectancy of the total population, we find that the average duration of life has not at all increased in the age of Kali, but it is rather decreasing drastically. Balam, bodily strength, is also decreasing. The Vedic literature states that 5,000 years ago, in the previous age, human beings, and even animals and plants, were larger and stronger. With the progress of the age of Kali, physical stature and strength will gradually diminish. Certainly, smriti, memory, is weakening. In former ages, human beings possessed superior memory, and they also did not encumber themselves with a terrible bureaucratic and technical society as we have done. Thus, essential information and abiding wisdom were preserved without recourse to writing. Of course, in the age of Kali, things are dramatically different. Text 2. In Kali Yuga, wealth alone will be considered the sign of a man's good birth, proper behavior, and fine qualities. And law and justice will be applied only on the basis of one's power. Purport. In the age of Kali, man is considered high class, middle class, or low class merely according to his financial status, regardless of his knowledge, culture, and behavior. In this age, there are many great industrialist and commercial cities with luxurious neighborhoods reserved for the wealthy. On beautiful tree-lined roads, within apparently aristocratic homes, it is not unusual to find many perverted, dishonest, and sinful activities taking place. According to Vedic criteria, a man is considered high class if his behavior is enlightened, and his behavior is considered enlightened if his activities are dedicated to promoting the happiness of all creatures. Every living being is originally happy because in all living bodies there is an eternal spiritual spark that partakes of the divine conscious nature of God. When our original spiritual awareness is revived, we become naturally blissful and satisfied in knowledge and peace. An enlightened or educated man should endeavor to revive his own spiritual understanding, and he should help others experiencing the same sublime consciousness. The great Western philosopher Socrates stated that if a man is enlightened, he will automatically act virtuously, and Srila Prabhupada confirmed this fact. But in the Kali Yuga, this obvious truth is disregarded, and the search for knowledge and virtue has been replaced by a vicious, animalistic competition for money. Those who prevail become the, quote, top dogs of, end quote, of modern society, and their consumer power grants them a reputation as most respectable, aristocratic, and well-educated. This verse also states that in the age of Kali, brute strength, bala eva, will determine law and, quote, justice, end quote. We should keep in mind that in the progressive Vedic culture, there was no artificial dichotomy between the spiritual and the public realms. All civilized people took it for granted that God is everywhere and that his laws are abiding upon all creatures. The Sanskrit word dharma, therefore, indicates one's social or public obligation as well as one's religious duty. Thus, responsibly caring for one's family is dharma, and engaging in the loving service of God is also dharma. This verse indicates, however, that in the age of Kali, the principle of, quote, might makes right, end quote, will hold sway. In the first chapter of this canto, we observed how this principle infiltrated in India's past. Similarly, as the Western world achieved political, economic, and technological hegemony over Asian lands, bogus propaganda was disseminated to the effect that Indian, and in general, all non-Western religion, theology, and philosophy are somehow primitive and unscientific, mere mythology and superstition. Fortunately, this arrogant irrational view is now dissipating, and people all over the world are beginning to appreciate the staggering wealth of spiritual philosophy and science available in the Sanskrit literature of India. In other words, many intelligent people no longer consider traditional Western religion or empirical science, which has virtually superseded religion as the official Western dogma, necessarily authoritative merely because the West has politically and economically subdued other geographic and ethnic configurations of humanity. Thus, there is now hope that spiritual issues can be contested and resolved on a philosophical level, and not merely by a crude test of arms. This next verse points out that the rule of law will be applied unequally to the powerful and the powerless. Already, in many nations, justice is available to only to those who can fight and pay for it. In a civilized state, every man, woman, and child must have equal and rapid access to a fair system of laws. In modern times, we sometimes refer to this as human rights. Certainly, human rights are one of the more obvious casualties of the age of Kali. Text 3. Men and women will live together merely because of superficial attraction, and success in business will depend on deceit. Womanliness and manliness will be judged according to one's expertise in sex, and a man will be known as a brahmana just by wearing his thread. Purport. Just as human life as a whole has a great and serious purpose, namely spiritual liberation, fundamental human institutions such as marriage and child rearing should also be dedicated to that great objective. Unfortunately, in the present age, the satisfaction of the sex impulse has become the overriding, if not the exclusive, reason for marriage. The sexual impulse, which induces the male and female of almost every species to combine physically, and in higher species also emotionally, is ultimately not a natural urge because it is based on the unnatural identification of the self with the body. Life itself is a spiritual phenomenon. It is the soul that lives and gives apparent life to the biological machine called the body. Consciousness is the soul's manifest energy, and thus consciousness, awareness itself, is originally an entirely spiritual event. When life, or consciousness, is confined within a biological machine and falsely mistakes itself to be that machine, material existence occurs and sex desire arises. God intends human life to be an opportunity for us to rectify this illusory mode of existence and return to the vast satisfaction of pure godly existence. But because our identification with the material body is a long historical affair, it is difficult for most people to immediately break free from the demands of the materially molded mind. Therefore, the Vedic scriptures prescribe sacred marriage, in which a so-called man and a so-called woman may combine in a regulated spiritual marriage sheltered by overarching religious injunctions. In this way, the candidate for self-realization who has selected family life can derive adequate satisfaction for his senses and simultaneously please the Lord within his heart by obeying religious injunctions. The Lord then purifies him of material desire. In Kali Yuga, this deep understanding has almost been lost, and, as stated in this verse, men and women combine like animals, solely on the basis of mutual attraction to bodies made of flesh, bone, membrane, blood, and so on. In other words, in our modern godless society, the weak, superficial intelligence of humanity rarely penetrates beyond the gross physical covering of the eternal soul, and thus family life has in most cases lost its higher purpose and value. A corollary point established in this verse is that in the age of Kali, a woman is considered, quote, a good woman, end quote, if she is sexually attractive and indeed sexually efficient. Similarly, a sexually attractive man is, quote, a good man, end quote. The best example of this superficiality is the incredible attention 20th century people give to materialistic movie stars, music stars, and other prominent figures in the entertainment industry. In fact, pursuing sexual experiences with various types of bodies is similar to drinking old wine from new bottles. But few people in the Kali Yuga can understand this. Finally, this verse states that in the age of Kali, a man will become known as a priest or brahmana merely by wearing ceremonial dress. In India, brahmanas wear a sacred thread, and in other parts of the world, members of the priestly class have other ornaments and symbols. But in the age of Kali, the symbols alone will suffice to establish a person as a religious leader, despite his ignorance of God. Text 4. A person's spiritual position will be ascertained merely according to external symbols, and on that same basis, people will change from one spiritual order to the next. A person's propriety will be seriously questioned if he does not earn a good living, and one who is very clever at juggling words will be considered a learned scholar. Purport. The previous verse stated that in the age of Kali, the priestly class will be recognized by external symbols alone, and this verse extends to the same principle to the other orders of society, namely the political or military class, the business or productive class, and finally the labor or artisan class. Modern sociologists have demonstrated that in those societies chiefly governed by the Protestant ethic, poverty is considered a sign of indolence, dirtiness, stupidity, immorality, and worthlessness. In a God-conscious society, however, many persons voluntarily decide to dedicate their lives not to material acquisition, but rather to the pursuit of knowledge and spirituality. Thus, a preference for the simple and the austere may indicate intelligence, self-control, and sensitivity to the higher purpose of life. Of course, in itself, poverty does not establish these virtues, but it may sometimes be the result of them. In the Kali Yuga, however, this possibility is often forgotten. Intellectuality is another casualty of the bewildering age of Kali. Modern so-called philosophers and scientists have created a technical, esoteric terminology for each branch of learning, and when they give lectures, people consider them learned, simply because of their ability to speak that which no one else can understand. In Western culture, The Greek sophists were among the first to systematically argue for rhetoric and, quote, efficiency, end quote, above wisdom and purity, and sophistry certainly flourishes in the 20th century. Modern universities have very little wisdom, although they do possess an virtual infinity of technical data. Although many modern thinkers are fundamentally ignorant of the higher spiritual reality, there are, so to speak, quote, good talkers, end quote, and most people simply don't notice their ignorance. Text 5. A person will be judged unholy if he does not have money, and hypocrisy will be accepted as virtue. Marriage will be arranged simply by verbal agreement, and a person will think that he is fit to appear in public if he has merely taken a bath. Purport. The word dhamba indicates a self-righteous hypocrite, someone not so much concerned with being saintly as with appearing saintly. In the age of Kali, there's a rather large number of self-righteous, hypocritical religious fanatics claiming to have the only way, the only truth, and the only light. In many Muslim countries, this mentality has resulted in brutal repression of religious freedom and thus destroyed the opportunity for enlightened spiritual dialectic. Fortunately, in much of the Western world, there is a system of free religious expression. Even in the West, however, self-righteous hypocrites considered sincere and saintly followers of other disciplines to be heathens and devils. Western religious fanatics are often addicted to many bad habits, such as smoking, drinking, sex, gambling, and animal slaughter. Although the followers of the Krishna consciousness movement strictly avoid illicit sex, intoxication, gambling, and animal killing, and although they dedicate their lives to the constant glorification of God, self-righteous hypocrites claim that such strict austerity and devotion to God are, quote, tricks of the devil, end quote. Thus, the sinful are promoted as religious, and the saintly are decried as demoniac. This pathetic incapacity to grasp the most rudimentary criterion of spirituality is a prominent symptom of Kali Yuga. In this age, the institution of marriage will degenerate. Indeed, already a marriage certificate is sometimes cynically rejected as, quote, a mere piece of paper, end quote. Forgetting the spiritual purpose of marriage and misunderstanding sex to be the goal of family life, lusty men and women directly engage in sexual affairs without the troublesome formalities and responsibilities of a legal relationship. Such foolish people argue that, quote, sex is natural, end quote. But if sex is natural, pregnancy and childbirth are equally natural. And for the child, it is certainly natural to be raised by the loving father and mother, and in fact to have the same father and mother throughout his life. Psychological studies confirm that a child needs to be cared for by both his father and his mother, and thus it is obviously natural for sex to be accompanied by a permanent marriage arrangement. Hypocritical people justify unrestricted sex by saying, quote, it is natural, end quote, but to avoid the natural consequence of sex, pregnancy, they use contraceptives, which certainly do not grow on trees. Indeed, contraceptives are not at all natural. Thus, foolishness and hypocrisy abound in the age of Kali. The verse concludes by saying that people will neglect to ornament their bodies properly in the present age. A human being should decorate his body with various religious ornaments. Vaishnavas mark their bodies with tilak, blessed with the holy name of God. But in the age of Kali, religious and mere even material formalities are thoughtlessly discarded. Text 6. A sacred place will be taken to consist of no more than a reservoir of water located at a distance, and beauty will be thought to depend on one's hairstyle. Filling the belly will become the goal of life, and one who is audacious will be accepted as truthful. He who can maintain a family will be regarded as an expert man, and the principles of religion will be observed only for the sake of reputation. Purport. In India, there are many sacred places through which holy rivers flow. Foolish persons eagerly seek redemption from their sins by bathing in these rivers, but do not take instruction from the learned devotees of the Lord who reside in such places. One should go to a holy place seeking spiritual enlightenment, not for just ritualistic bathing. In this age, people tirelessly arrange their hair in different styles, trying to enhance their facial beauty and sexuality. They do not know that actual beauty comes from within the heart, from the soul, and that only a person who is pure is truly attractive. As the difficulties of this age increase, filling one's belly will be the mark of success, and one who can maintain his own family will be considered brilliant in economic affairs. Religion will be practiced, if at all, only for the sake of reputation and without any essential understanding of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Text 7. As the earth becomes crowded with corrupt population, whoever among any of the social classes shows himself to be the strongest will gain political power. Text 8. Losing their wives and properties to such avaricious and merciless rulers who will behave no better than ordinary thieves, the citizens will flee to the mountains and forests. Text 9. Harassed by famine and excessive taxes, people will resort to eating leaves, roots, flesh, wild honey, fruits, flowers, and seeds. Struck by drought, they will become completely ruined. Purport. Srimad Bhagavatam authoritatively describes the future of our planet. Just as a leaf disconnected from a plant or tree dries up, withers, and degenerates, when human society is disconnected from the Supreme Lord, it withers up and disintegrates in violence and chaos. Despite our computers and rockets, if the Supreme Lord does not send rain, we shall all starve. Text 10. The citizens will suffer greatly from the cold, wind, heat, rain, and snow. They will be further tormented by quarrels, hunger, thirst, disease, and severe anxiety. Text 11. The maximum duration of life for human beings in Kali Yuga will become 50 years. Texts 12 through 16. By the time the age of Kali ends, the bodies of all creatures will be greatly reduced in size, and the religious principles and followers of Varnashram will be ruined. The path of the Vedas will be completely forgotten in human society, and so-called religion will be mostly atheistic. The kings will be mostly thieves. The occupations of men will be stealing, lying, and needless violence, and all the social classes will be reduced to the lowest level of Shudras. Cows will be like goats, spiritual hermitages will be no different from mundane houses, and family ties will extend no further than the immediate bonds of marriage. Most plants and herbs will be tiny, and all trees will appear like dwarf shami trees. Clouds will be full of lightning, homes will be devoid of piety, and all human beings will have become like asses. At that time, the Supreme Personality of Godhead will appear on the earth. Acting with the power of pure spiritual goodness, he will rescue eternal religion. Purport. Significantly, this verse points out that most so-called religions in this age will be atheistic. Pasanda Pachare Dharme. In confirmation of the Bhagavatam's prediction, the United States Supreme Court has recently ruled that to be considered a religion a system of belief need not recognize a supreme being. Also, many atheistic voidistic belief systems, often imported from the Orient, have attracted the attention of modern atheistic scientists who expound on the similarities between Eastern and Western voidism in fashionable esoteric books. These verses vividly describe many unsavory symptoms of the age of Kali. Ultimately, at the end of this age, Lord Krishna will descend as Kalki and remove the thoroughly demoniac persons from the face of the earth. Text 17. Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the spiritual master of all moving and non-moving living beings, and the supreme soul of all, takes birth to protect the principles of religion and to relieve his saintly devotees from the reactions of material work. Text 18. Lord Kalki will appear in the home of the most eminent Brahmana of Shambhala village, the great soul Vishnuyasa. Text 19 and 20. Lord Kalki, the Lord of the universe, will mount his swift horse Devadatta and, sword in hand, travel over the earth, exhibiting his 8 mystic opulences and 8 special qualities of Godhead, displaying his unequaled effulgence and riding with great speed. He will kill by the millions those thieves who have dared to dress as kings. Purport. This verse describes the thrilling pastimes of Lord Kalki. Anyone would be attracted by the sight of a powerful, beautiful man riding on a wonderful horse at lightning speed, chastising the devastating, cruel, demonic people with the sword in his hand. Of course, fanatical materialists may argue that this picture of Lord Kali is a mere anthropomorphic creation of the human mind, a mythological deity created by people who need to believe in some superior being. But this argument is not logical, nor does it prove anything. It is merely the opinion of certain people. We need water, but that does not mean man creates water. We also need food, oxygen, and many other things that we do not create. Since our general experience is that our needs correspond to available objects existing in the external world, that we appear to need a Supreme Lord would tend to indicate that in fact there is a Supreme Lord. In other words, nature endows us with a sense of need for things that actually exist and that are in fact necessary for our well-being. Similarly, we experience a need for God because we are in fact part of God and cannot live without Him. At the end of Kali Yuga, this same God will appear as the mighty Kalki avatar and beat the pollution out of the demons. Text 21. After all the imposter kings have been killed, the residents of the cities and towns will feel the breezes carrying the most sacred fragrance of the sandalwood paste and other decorations of Lord Vasudev, and their minds will thereby become transcendentally pure. Purport. Nothing can surpass the sublime experience of being dramatically rescued by a great hero who happens to be the Supreme Lord. The death of the demons at the end of Kali Yuga is accompanied by fragrant spiritual breezes, and thus the atmosphere becomes most enchanting. Text 22. When Lord Vasudev, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appears in their hearts in his transcendental form of goodness, the remaining citizens will abundantly repopulate the earth. Text 23. When the Supreme Lord has appeared on earth as Kalki, the maintainer of religion, Satyuga will begin, and human society will bring forth progeny in the mode of goodness. Text 24. When the moon, the sun, and Brihaspati are together in the constellation Karkata, and all three enter simultaneously into the lunar mansion Pushya, at that exact moment the age of Satya, or Krita, will begin. Text 25. Thus I have described all the kings, past, present, and future, who belonged to the dynasties of the sun and the moon. Text 26. From your birth up to the coronation of King Nanda, 1,150 years will pass. Purport. Although Shukadev Goswami previously described approximately 1,500 years of royal dynasties, it is to be understood that some overlapping occurred between kings. Therefore, the present chronological calculation should be taken as authoritative. Text 27-28. Of the seven stars forming the constellation of the seven sages, Pralaha and Kratu are the first to rise in the night sky. If a line running north and south were drawn through their midpoint, whichever of the lunar mansions this line passes through is said to be the ruling asterism of the constellation for that time. The seven sages will remain connected with that particular lunar mansion for 100 human years. Currently, during your lifetime, they are situated in the nakshatra called Magha. Text 29. The Supreme Lord, Vishnu, is brilliant like the sun and is known as Krishna. When he returned to the spiritual sky, Kali entered this world, and people then began to take pleasure in sinful activities. Text 30. As long as Lord Shri Krishna, the husband of the goddess of fortune, touched the earth with his lotus feet, Kali was powerless to subdue this planet. Purport. Although during the time of Lord Krishna's presence on earth, Kali had entered the earth to a slight extent through the impious activities of Duryodhana and his allies, Lord Krishna consistently suppressed Kali's influence. Kali could not flourish until Lord Krishna had left the earth. Text 31. When the constellation of the seven sages is passing through the lunar mansion Magha, the age of Kali begins. It comprises 1,200 years of the demigods. Text 32. When the great sages of the Saptarshit constellation pass from Magha to Purvashada, Kali will have his full strength beginning from King Nanda and his dynasty. Text 33. Those who scientifically understand the past declare that on the very day that Lord Krishna departed for the spiritual world, the influence of the age of Kali began. Purport. Although technically Kali Yuga was to begin during the time of Lord Krishna's presence on earth, this fallen age had to wait meekly for the departure of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Text 34. After the 1,000 celestial years of Kali Yuga, the Satyuga will manifest again. At that time, the minds of all men will become self-effulgent. Text 35. Thus I have described the royal dynasty of Manu as it is known on this earth. One can similarly study the history of the Vaishyas, Shudras, and Brahmanas living in the various ages. Purport. Just as the dynasty of kings includes exalted and insignificant, virtuous and wicked monarchs, varieties of human characters are found in the intellectual, commercial, and laboring orders of society. Text 36. These personalities, who were great souls, are now known only by their names. They exist only in accounts from the past, and only their fame remains on the earth. Purport. Although one may consider oneself to be a great, powerful leader, he will ultimately end up as a name in a long list of names. In other words, it is useless to be attached to power and position in the material world. Text 37. Devapi, the brother of Maharshantanu, and Maru, the descendant of Ikshvaku, both possess great mystic strength and are living even now in the village of Kalapa. Text 38. At the end of the age of Kali, these two kings, having received instruction directly from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva, will return to human society and reestablish the eternal religion of man, characterized by the divisions of Varna and Ashram, just as it was before. purport. According to this and the previous verse, the two great kings who will reestablish human culture after the end of Kali Yuga have already descended to the earth, where they are patiently waiting to render their devotional service to Lord Vishnu. Text 39. The cycle of four ages, Satya, Treta, Dvapara, and Kali, continues perpetually among living beings on this earth, repeating the same general sequence of events. Text 40. My dear King Prickett, all these kings I have described, as well as other human beings, come to this earth and stake their claims, but ultimately they must all give up this world and meet their destruction. Purport. After death, the body may be burned, buried, and eaten by worms, or it may be thrown in the street or forest to be eaten by animals who will pass out its remnants as stool, or it may be burned and converted into ashes. Therefore, one should not pave his way to hell by using his temporary body to endure the bodies of other living beings. In this verse, the word Bhuta includes non-human life forms who are also creatures of God. One should give up all envious violence and learn to see God in everything by the process of Krishna consciousness. Text 42. The materialistic king thinks, quote, "This unbounded earth was held by my predecessors and is now under my sovereignty. How can I arrange it to remain in the hands of my sons, grandsons, and other descendants?" End quote. Purport. This is an example of foolish possessiveness. Text 43. Although the foolish may accept the body made of earth, water, and fire as, quote, me, end quote, and this earth as, quote, mine, end quote, in every case, they have ultimately abandoned both their body and the earth and passed away into oblivion. Purport. Although the soul is eternal, our so-called family tradition and earthly fame will certainly pass into oblivion. Text 44. My dear King Prickett, all these kings who tried to enjoy the earth by their strength were reduced by the force of time to nothing more than historical events. Purport. The word Rajan, quote, O king, end quote, is significant in this verse. Prickett Maharaj was preparing to give up his body and go back home, back to Godhead, and Shukadeva Goswami, his most merciful spiritual master, devastated any possible attachment that he might have to the position of king by showing the ultimate insignificance of such a position. By the causeless mercy of the spiritual master, one is prepared to go back home, back to Godhead. The spiritual master teaches one to relax one's strong grip on material illusion and leave the kingdom of Maya behind. Although Shukadeva Goswami speaks very bluntly within this chapter about the so-called glory of the material world, he is exhibiting the causeless mercy of the spiritual master who takes his surrendered disciple back to the kingdom of Godhead, Vaikuntha. Thus end the purports of the humble servants of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada to the 12th canto, 2nd chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled The Symptoms of Kali Yuga.